Everyone, my name is Vidhi Chauhan and I'm a professor in Suresh Gyan Vihar School of Pharmacy and which is Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. So today we are discussing pharmaceutical organic chemistry second, which comes in your third semester. And in this, we are going to discuss the unit first, that is your benzene and its derivative. So in our last lecture, we have already discussed something about benzene and its derivatives. So today we are going to discuss today the learning objective of this topic is in this the benzene and its derivative. In this we are going to study about the different type of chemical reactions of benzene and to study different parameter how the different products are formed from benzene. So here today the learning objective is that in this we are going to study about the chemical reaction related to the benzene, how the benzene is reacting with other substituents, the other reagents, and how we are getting the different products in case of benzene. So here in our last lecture we have already studied about what is benzene, its nomenclature, its derivatives nomenclature, and how the benzene, if something is added on its ortho para position, then how we are naming it, and how the benzene is a benzene molecular formula is determined, and who firstly discovered benzene, and who has given the structure of benzene, that it is not a it does not have a straight chain, but it can comes in a ring, in a unsaturated, which is highly unsaturated than your cyclohexane. And the method of preparation of benzene, how benzene is prepared from the other molecules, and how we can prepare it on the industry scale, and also from on the laboratory scale. So today we are going to study about the chemical reactions of benzene, that how chemical how benzene chemically reacting with the other reagents and giving the different products. So firstly, the characteristic reaction on benzene involves substitution in which resonance stabilized ring is preserved. So here it says that the benzene involves substitution. As I've already told you in the last lecture, that the benzene shows the substitution reactions. In case of benzene, there is a substitution of the hydrogen. Hydrogen abstracts from the benzene position from the first place, and the other reagent to which we are reacting, that comes to that place. So there is a substitution in the reaction. There a substitution is happening in this benzene. So it involves substitution in which resonance stabilized ring is preserved, and this reaction is called aromatic substitution, because the substitution is having is going on this aromatic compound. That is why it is known as substitution, aromatic substitution. Next, compared to sigma bonds, pi electrons are loosely held. So here, as we compare the sigma and the pi bond, the pi bonds are loosely held. They can be broken. We can also broke it, and are available to the reagent. And these pi bonds are easily available to the reagents. That is seeking electrons, means the reagents which need electrons, which are seeking for the electron, which are electron deficient, so they need electron. So these pi bonds are loosely held, so these can be easily available to these reagents which are electron deficient. So typically reaction of benzene is electrophilic substitution reaction. So here the benzene shows the electrophilic substitution reaction, where hydrogen of aromatic ring is substituted by an atom or group. Here it says that the benzene is benzene shows the electrophilic substitution reaction. Electrophilic substitution means that the electrophiles are the reagents that need electron, are the atoms or the groups that need electron, and that electron can be taken by from the benzene. So here electrophilic substitution reaction, where hydrogen, the hydrogen which is present on the topmost, on the first carbon or for carbon are abstracted from that position, is substituted by an atom or group that is present in the reagent to which the benzene is reacting, doing reaction with it. So here, so reaction of benzene is electrophilic substitution reaction, where hydrogen of aromatic ring is substituted by an atom or group. So here you can see AR simply shows, signifies your benzene ring, and H is for your hydrogen. So this can be written as, and if the reagent contains this H, we can denote it with anything, any atom or any group. So this H is substituted by this X. So this is your electrophilic substitution reaction. Because H is substituted from this position and the another reagent is added to that benzene ring, that aromatic ring. So here, aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction is shown by this aromatic ring. Next, general mechanism of electrophilic substitution reaction. So here, the mechanism for this electrophilic substitution reaction is aromatic substitution reaction are initiated by the attack of electrophile on the ring, followed by the elimination of proton. So here, aromatic substitution reaction that is initiated, that is started by the attack of the electrophile. Electrophile means the electron deficient. It needs electron. It needs electron. So it attacks to the ring of benzene. And after that, there is an elimination of the proton from the ring. So here, the aromatic substitution reaction means that there is attack of the electrophile on the aromatic ring. After that, there is an abstraction or there is a removal of, or you can say elimination of proton. Proton here is H positive. H positive means that H, that the benzene ring, that the carbon present attached with that H, give its electron to the carbon. Carbon withdraw the electron from the hydrogen and that becomes proton, H positive. So that phenomena, that reaction is known as, is called electrophilic substitution reaction, because the electrophile is substituting the hydrogen, the proton, from the benzene ring, from the ring. So this reaction is known as electrophilic substitution reaction. So here, benzene with its pi electron behave as an electron-rich system. So benzene is having the pi electron system. That is why it is having electron-rich system. Okay, so it is having electrons. So it behaves as an electron-rich system. And the electron in the pi clouds are readily available to form a new bond. So here, the pi bond that is present in the benzene, that are readily available. They are always available for the electrophile to attack and to form a new bond with the electron deficient species. That is your electrophile. So here, the pi bond that are pi cloud, or you can say the pi bonds, pi electrons that are present in the benzene ring, they are readily available for the electrophile, for the electron deficient species, so that they can form a new bond with that reagent or the electron deficient species, or you can say the electrophile. The electrophilic substitution reaction follows the following mechanism. So here the mechanism of the electrophilic substitution reaction is given. Next step first. In your first step, what would happen? First is generation of electrophile either by spontaneous dissociation of reagent or by acid catalyzed dissociation. Here, firstly, what is happening that there is a generation of electrophile, means the electrophile is generating. Okay, so here this reagent, that ENU, ENU means E is your electrophile and NU is your nucleophile. Okay, so here this electrophile is generated either by the spontaneous dissociation of reagent or by acid catalyzed dissociation. Means here it is by the dissociation of the reagent or by the acid catalyzed dissociation. So here, this edge E will having, which is having the positive positive sign, it shows that it is not having sufficient electron with it. So it is having what? It is deficient, electron deficient. That is why E is having positive sign. Plus Nu. So this Nu is your electron withdrawn. This Nu has withdrawn electron from this E. So it is having more electrons. So this E Nu plus A negative. A and negative is your other reagent. After that, see, this E Nu, either by the dissociation, see, the dissociation is happening. E Nu, first step. By spontaneous dissociation. So here normally dissociation is happening in E and U. Here you can see the dissociation of reagent E and U. So E is having the positive charge because this NU has withdrawn electron from this E electrophile. So it is having the positive, or by the acid catalyze. So here this acid is causing the dissociation of this reagent. So here you can see this NU is attached to this A, that is your acid, and there it is having the positive sign. It is Nu is having the positive sign because this A has formed a bond with this Nu. After that, this Nu and A will form a bond, and this Nu will withdraw electron from this E, that is your electrophile. So this E is now formed by this acid catalyzed dissociation. So here the E now, this Nu has withdrawn electron from this E, and E is having the deficient of electron. It is not having electron. It is having less electrons. That is why E is having the positive charge. So first, how it is generated? Electrophile is generated. Electrophile is generated by the spontaneous dissociation of reagent, or it can be generated by the acid catalyzed dissociation. Second step is your formation of the pi complex, first then sigma complex. So here sigma complex formed by association of electrophile with the aromatic ring in the sigma, pi complex. An electrophile is not attached to any specific position of its of ring, but later it rearranges to give sigma complex. Firstly, this pi complex formed by the association. This electrophile is associated with this pi complex with the ring, aromatic ring. And in this pi complex, an electrophile is not attached. The electrophile is not attached to any specific position of ring. So this electrophile is not attached to any specific position on the ring, but later it arranges. But later, after some time, after after it arranges to give this sigma complex. And the sigma complex is a resonance hybrid. So here the sigma complex is the resonance hybrid that is shown by the dotted structure. So here the sigma complex is a resonance hybrid of stabilized carbonium ion produced by the attack of electrophile on benzene ring. So when this electrophile attack on the benzene ring, then there is a formation of a resonance hybrid. This sigma complex, this resonance hybrid is formed, which is a stabilized carbonium ion that is produced by the attack of the electrophile on the ring. So next, in the third step, what is happening? In the third step, there is a proton, H positive, is then eliminated from sigma complex by the base to yield the final substitution product. After then, this proton, H positive, is eliminated from the sigma complex. From the sigma complex, H positive is eliminated, and there is a base that is present, and there is finally a substitution product is formed. So in your first step, what is happening? First step, there is a generation of your electrophile by the two spontaneous dissociation of reagent, or you can say by the acid catalyzed dissociation. Next step, there is a formation of sigma pi complex first. And after then, there is a formation of this sigma complex. Thirdly, in the third step, there is a proton H positive, which is then eliminated from the benzene ring from this pi complex and by the base to yield a final substitution product means here this H positive, that is your proton that is present on your benzene ring, is then abstracted or removed from that position, and after that there is the base, that electrophile is then reacted and then is attached to that sigma complex, and there is the final substitution product is formed. Next, this is your mechanism. As you can see in this mechanism, in your first step, this is the addition of your electrophile making the CE bond, means CE carbon electrophile bond. So here, this electrophile is attached to this carbon and there is a formation of the CE bond. This is a slow step, okay? This electrophile is, how this electrophile is formed? By the spontaneous dissociation or by the acid catalyzed reaction. Uske, next, after that, there is a formation of this resonance stabilized carbanium ion. So here you can see there is a formation of this sigma bond. After that, the bond are delocalized. There is a resonance in this ring. After that, you can see here, if this H is attached to, sorry, this electrophile is attached to this position of the carbon and there is H also present, then here this carbon will get the positive sign. Okay, so if this here the carbon is having the positive, so here this bond is broken and here it is formed, here two bonds are formed here. So after that, these bonds are shifted to this position. So here you can see that here you get this carbon positive charge. After that, there is a resonance happening in this ring. You can see here resonance is happening. Okay, here, see this bond is resonating. Bond is shifting from the here to this position. After that, here this carbon will get the positive sign. Okay, if this carbon will get the positive sign, then this bond will all shift from this position. Then this carbon will get the positive sign. So this is a resonance is happening in this aromatic ring, and there is a formation of this arenium ion. Arene, we say that arene. So here positive sign is present on the carbon. That is why it is known as arenium ion is formed. After that, there is a base. Base means from where this electrophile is dissociated. So then the base contain the negative charge. So this hydrogen then this carbon will withdraw electron from this hydrogen, and this hydrogen will remove from here, from this position, and it will then connect with this, will attach with this base, and there is a formation of this product. This substitution is happened here, electrophile substitution. So this electrophile is now attached properly on this benzene ring. So here there is a formation, see in the steps, proton transfer, restoring aromaticity, and this H is then attached with this base, and there is a formation of this, and there is a electrophilic aromatic substitution. So here in the first step, what is happening? The electrophile is added on the ring, and there is a carbon electrophile bond. After that, there is a in the next step, what is happening? There is a hydrogen which has to be abstracted from this position. But after that, this bond is break, and this carbon will get the positive sign because there is electron deficiency on this carbon. So after that, this carbon will withdraw electron from this bond. And this carbon, there is a formation of this bond. And after that, this carbon is having the positive sign. Then again, this bond then shift from this position to here. Then this carbon will get the positive sign. Now, this hydrogen, there is a resonance. This is the resonance happening in this ring. After that, this hydrogen is taken by this base, because this base is having the negative charge, and this hydrogen, which is your proton, this hydrogen electron will be withdrawn by this carbon, and here this, then after that, this H positive, which is your proton, that is be taken by this base, and here what is formed? The base and H is attached, and this electrophile is formed. So here, this is the mechanism of your electrophilic aromatic substitution. And this is known as your arenium ions. This is your anemium ions. Next, halogenation of benzene. So here in your chemical reaction, there are so many types of reaction happening. Halogenation, sulfonation, nitration, and Friedel-Crafts alkylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation. So these are the type of reactions that are happening in this chemical reaction of this benzene. And first we are discussing this halogenation of benzene. So this is a type of your electrophilic aromatic substitution. Means here again the halogen will get attached to the carbon ring, to the benzene ring, and the hydrogen is abstracted from that position. So here the halogenation of benzene, this is the reaction type of this halogenation of benzene is your electrophilic aromatic substitution. And in this, an electrophilic aromatic halogenation is a type of electrophilic aromatic substitution. So here, this electrophilic aromatic halogenation is a type of electrophilic aromatic substitution. So here, in this halogenation, there is a substitution is happening. So in this, organic reaction is typically of aromatic compounds and a very useful method for adding substituent to an aromatic system. So this organic reaction in this aromatic compounds is a very useful method. In this method, we are adding the substituent to the aromatic ring, and the substituent will be your halogen. So the halogen is adding to the aromatic ring. In this, a few type of aromatic compounds that such as phenol will react without a catalyst, but for typical benzene derivatives with less reactive substrate, a Lewis acid catalyst is required. So in this aromatic compound, there is a need of a catalyst. But in case of phenol, there is no need of the catalyst. It can be substituted without the help of the catalyst. But in other reactions, in other type of benzene derivatives, they need with less reactive substrate, they need a Lewis acid catalyst. So what are the Lewis acid catalysts? A Lewis acid catalyst is required. So the Lewis acid catalyst includes this AlCl3, FeCl3, FeBr3, and zinc chloride. So the Lewis acid catalysts are having the donating power because they are having the lone pair with them. So they donate electrons. So here, they are acting as a catalyst. Catalyst means that they are need in the reaction for slowing the reaction or fasting the reaction, or they itself used in the reaction, but after that they will remove as it is from the reaction. They are not involved fully in the reaction. So here these work by forming a highly electrophilic complex, which is then attacked by the benzene ring. So here these are forming a electrophilic complex, and the electrophilic complex which is these catalysts are working and forming a electrophilic complex, highly electrophilic complex, and after that they are reacting to the benzene. Next, electrophilic species. So what will be the electrophilic species in case of halogenation of benzene? So halonium ions are the electrophilic species, and that is your X positive. Here X means your chlorine or your bromine. So here the chlorine, which is having the positive charge, will attack to the benzene ring. So here formed by the removal of this halide ring by the Lewis acid catalyst. So here they are formed by the removal of a halide ion by the Lewis acid catalyst, and their restricted iodine ion or your fluoride ions are usually introduced using alternative methods. So here these are restricted, and these are usually introduced where alternative methods are used. So here generally the reaction is given. So in this reaction, you can see here the benzene ring is given. Here the benzene ring is given, and X is your halonium, halogen. एक फिजियो हेलोजन एंड दिस इज योर कैटलिस्ट. सो कैटलिस्ट इज योर लुईस एसिड कैटलिस्ट एंड हेयर दिस प्रोडक्ट इज फ्रॉम योर हेलोजन इज एडेड टू दिस पोजिशन एंड दिस एच which is abstracted from this ring is then attached with this base, that halogen, because here are two molecules of chlorine are present. Okay, so in halogenation reaction of benzene, what we have studied that this is an electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. Okay, first thing. Second, in this case, there is the adding of the substituent to the aromatic system. So in this case, the substituent will be a halogen. Thirdly, in the case of your phenol, there is no need of your catalyst. But in case of some of the benzene, which is having the less reactive substrates are present, they need a catalyst. So here, in halogenation of benzene, we need a Lewis catalyst, which is your Lewis acid catalyst. So Lewis acid catalysts are having your lone pair with them. So here the examples are AlCl3, FeCl3, FeBr3, zinc chloride, ZnCl2. So these Lewis acid catalysts work by forming a highly electrophilic complex, and then they attack to the aromatic ring. Next, the electrophilic species that will attack to the ring will be your halogen, that is donated by the X. Okay, or you can say the halonium ion. So here, this is formed by the removal of halide ion by the Lewis acid catalyst. So here we are using this chlorine and bromine. Next, there is a restriction for iodine and fluorine are usually introduced using alternative method. And the general reaction for this, you can see here, the benzene ring is given plus X and a catalyst is given. So you can see halogen is added on this benzene ring, and X is for your halogen, and your catalyst means here Lewis acid catalysts are used, which are AlCl3, FeCl3, FeBr3, and zinc chloride. Next, the first reaction is your chlorination of benzene. So in this chlorination of benzene, you can see this is your general reaction where benzene ring is given and the chlorine is given. And this catalyst, Lewis acid catalyst, is given FeCl3. So here chlorine is added to this carbon, and there is a formation of this chlorobenzene. And here this hydrochloric acid is also formed. So the mechanism for this reaction, for the chlorination of benzene, is in the step first, you can see there is a formation of this chlorinium ion. So here you can see, firstly, this we need an electrophile. So here we can, I have already told you that there will be a spontaneous dissociation or by the acid catalyst. So here this electrophile is formed by the acid catalyst. So here you can see this chlorine, which is acting as a Lewis base. This chlorine is then reacted with this ferric chloride, which is our Lewis acid. After that, a complex is formed. A molecular complex is formed, and this chlorine will get the positive charge. This chlorine will get a positive charge. After that, this chlorine will withdraw electron from this chlorine. Okay, so here there is a bond which is formed, and FeCl4 negative is formed, and this chlorine will get a positive sign because this chlorine has withdrawn electron from this chlorine. So this chlorine is get chlorine will get the positive sign. And after that, here is the formation of this electrophile. So here electrophile is formed and an ion pair containing a chlorinium ion. So here you can see, after that, this is your chlorinium ion. This is your chlorinium ion. As I've told you in the last slide, that there is a formation of this halonium ion. So this is your chlorinium ion. So in the step second, you will see there is an attack of the chlorinium ion on the ring. So this chlorinium ion will attack to this benzene ring. So this is a slow step and is also a rate determining step. Okay, so here you can see this chlorine will attach to this position of the benzene, and after that you see there is a resonance stabilized cation intermediate is formed. The positive charge is delocalized onto the free atom of the ring. See here. So here when this chlorine is attached and there is also a hydrogen, then this will carbon will get the positive sign. After that, this bond is shifted to this position. There is a formation of the bond, and this carbon will get the positive sign. After that, here again this bond will shift to this position, and there is a formation of the positive sign on this carbon. So here the bond is formed into this position. So here you can see this is your arenium ion formed. So here the resonance stabilized cation intermediate, the positive charge is delocalized onto three atoms of the ring. So in the step third, you can see a proton. After that, a proton is transferred, regenerates the aromatic character of your ring. So here you can see this FeCl3 is removed as it is from the reaction. This catalyst is removed as it is from the reaction, and this chlorine will get the negative on its negative. This chlorine will get the negative charge, and this hydrogen, this will act as a base. This hydrogen then abstracted, or you can say the removed from this position, and will then attack to this chlorine. So there is a formation of this hydrochloric acid, and this reaction will be a fast step reaction, and there is a formation of this chlorobenzene. So from benzene, we have formed a chlorobenzene. So this is your chlorination of your benzene. Next reaction is your bromination of benzene. So next reaction is your benzene. You can see there is a benzene ring. Then this Br2, that is your bromine, attack to this aromatic ring in the presence of your Lewis acid, that is your FeBr3, which is a catalyst. And there is a formation of this bromo ring, and there is a HBr is formed. So in this step also the same process will happen as that of the chlorination. So in this also the step from first there is a generation of your electrophile. After that, this electrophile, there is a formation of this bromanium ion is formed, and this bromanium ion will then attack to the benzene ring, and there will be a formation of the resonance stabilized structure. And after that, the hydrogen from the aromatic ring will abstract from that position, and it will then will attack to this Br, and there is a formation of this hydrogen bromide, and this FeBr3 will removed as it is, and there is a formation of this bromobenzene. So in the halogenation of benzene, we have discussed about the chlorination of benzene. Secondly, we have discussed about the bromination of benzene, chlorine as well as the bromine. So the third reaction, see here, as I've told you in step first, there is a formation of this electrophile and take place, must be activated. After that, electrophile attack and formation of the sigma bond is formed, sigma complex is formed, you can see here. After that, there is a loss of this proton, and finally we are getting the product. So here bromobenzene is formed, and this Lewis acid catalyst, and this is hydrogen bromide. Next is your nitration and sulfonation. So in your nitration and sulfonation of benzene are the two examples of your electrophilic aromatic substitution. And the nitronium ion, this is your NO2 positive, and your sulfur dioxide from are the electrophiles. This nitronium ion and the sulfur dioxide both are the electrophiles, and they individually react with this benzene, and it gives the nitrobenzene. And the secondly, the sulfonation gives you benzene sulfonic acid, and the nitration gives you nitrobenzene. And we are reacting the benzene with this nitronium ion, and the which is acting as electrophile, and finally we are getting this nitrobenzene as a product. And in case of sulfonation, they we are reacting the benzene ring with the sulfur trioxide, and there is a formation of this benzene sulfonic acid respectively. Next, First is your nitration of benzene. So in this case, you can see the benzene ring is reacting with this HNO3, nitric acid, and in the presence of your H2SO4, which is your sulfuric acid. And there is a formation of this nitrobenzene. So here, nitrobenzene is formed and a water molecule is removed out from here. So in this, in your mechanism, the first step is your generation of your electrophile. So in your electrophile, you can see this HNO3 is activated. This is activated with the sulfuric acid. So here, sulfuric acid is acting as a catalyst. So here, the sulfuric acid, you can see HNO3 is activated with sulfuric acid through protonation, which then causes the loss of water molecule and form a nitronium ion, which is a stronger electrophile. So here you can see this HNO3. This is, you can see this is your sulfuric acid. And when this H is removed from this sulfuric acid, then there is a formation of this water molecule from here. You can see here, this is formed. And after that, from this nitric acid, there is a removal of this water molecule from here, and there is a formation of this nitronium ion is formed, which is your stronger electrophile. Next is your nitration of benzene. So in your nitration of benzene, you can see the step 2 and step 3, there is a formation of the sigma complex and then elimination of proton H positive and form a sigma complex take place to get the final product. So here you can see this benzene ring is then attacked by this strong nucleophile, and there is a resonance happening in the benzene ring. And after that, this H is then removed, abstracted from this position, and this will again attach to this OSO3H, and there is a formation of this H2SO4, which was acting as a catalyst, and there is a formation of this nitrobenzene. So this whole process is your step 2 and the step 3. In your step 2, you can see here, this nitro is added to the benzene ring. There is a formation of this resonance, stabilized ion is formed. After that, the H in your step 3, what is happening? This proton H is removed from this position, and this get attacked to this sulfuric acid ion that is formed, and this then form a sulfuric acid, proper sulfuric acid will form, and we get a final product that is your nitrobenzene. Now the third step, that is your sulfonation. So your sulfonation is a reversible reaction that produces benzene sulfonic acid, and by adding sulfur trioxide and fuming sulfuric acid, the reaction is reversed by adding hot aqueous acid to benzene sulfuric acid to produce benzene. So here, sulfonation is a reversible reaction. Here, firstly, you can form benzene is attacked by your sulfur trioxide, and there is a formation of this benzene sulfonic acid. This is happening in the presence of your sulfuric acid, H2SO4, fuming H2SO4. Okay, so this reaction, it can be reversed. So here, this reaction, the benzene sulfonic acid can be reversed if we add your hot aqueous acid in your benzene sulfonic acid, then there is a formation of this benzene. So this is your reversible. Firstly, from benzene, we are getting the benzene sulfonic acid. Then if we want a benzene again, then we are adding the hot aqueous acid to this benzene sulfonic acid, and we are getting a benzene. Next is your mechanism of sulfonation. So in your first step, there will be a generation of electrophile. So the sulfur in your sulfur trioxide is a electrophilic, because oxygen pulls electron away from it, as oxygen is very electronegative. So in this sulfur trioxide, there is a presence of the oxygen in the sulfur. So the sulfur will act as an electrophile, and this because there is a oxygen present in them, and in oxygen we know that they are very high, electronegative, and they pull electrons, they withdraw electrons. So here, so the sulfur is acting as electrophilic, and to produce benzene sulfonic acid from benzene, Here we are also adding fuming sulfuric acid and sulfur trioxide are added, and this fuming sulfuric acid also referred to as oleum. So we can also say fuming sulfuric acid as oleum, which is a concentrated solution of dissolved sulfur trioxide in sulfuric acid. If we dissolve the sulfur trioxide in your sulfuric acid, then there is a concentrated solution, and that is known as your oleum. Okay, next you can see the step 2 and step 3. After that, this sulfur, this is your sulfonic acid, sulfur trioxide. So this is then from the sulfur, oxygen will withdraw electron and the sulfur will acting as a electrophile. Then the benzene attacks the sulfur and subsequent proton transfer occurs to produce benzene sulfonic acid. So here you can see again this benzene then attacks the sulfur, which is acting as an electrophile. So there is an addition of the sulfur trioxide to this benzene ring, and you can see there is again happening a resonance in this benzene ring. And after that, this hydrogen from here, from the benzene ring, is removed, or you can say is extracted, and then attached to this sulfonic acid, and there is a formation of the benzene sulfonic acid. So here you can see the benzene attacked the sulfur and the subsequent proton transfer occurred to produce benzene sulfonic acid, and the formation of sigma complex and then elimination of proton H positive from the sigma complex take place, and we get the final product, your benzene sulfonic acid we get. Next is your Friedel-Crafts acylation. So this reaction involves the introduction of your RCO, which is your acyl group, in the aromatic ring in presence of your AlCl3, BF3 and FeCl3, which are your Lewis acid catalyst. So here you can see benzene in the presence of your RCOCl. Okay, this is your and there is a formation of this benzene, which is having your COR group, ketone, and plus HCl. So here you can see the mechanism. Here acyl chloride is then the first step, involves the generation of an electrophile, that is your acylium ion. You can see here acyl chloride is then reacted with this Lewis acid catalyst, and there is a formation of this acylium ion is formed. And there, after that, there is in the step second, the second step involves the attack of this acylium ion on benzene and as a new electrophile to form a complex. So here you can see there is a formation of this complex is formed here. After that, in the step third involves the departure of the proton. So here the proton is then again removed from this position in order for the aromaticity to return to benzene, and then it will get attached to this chlorine. So there is a formation of this product, this AlCl3 and this HCl. Now next is your Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So this step, this reaction involves the attack of an alkyl group in benzene in presence of your anhydrous aluminium chloride. Same, the Lewis acid catalyst is used in the formation of this product in alkylation. So here this is your Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, and there is a transformation of ARH to your AR is your benzene ring. So here benzene is converted to this methyl benzene. So here the mechanism for this reaction begins with the generation of the methyl carbocation. So here, firstly, the methyl carbocation is formed from this methyl chloride, or you can say if you have taken the bromide, then there is the from this methyl chloride. The carbocation then reacts with the pi electron system of the benzene to form a non-aromatic carbocation. And after that, there is a loss of the proton. So that there can be there again can be the re-establishment of this aromaticity in this benzene. So here the step first, you can see here there is a formation of the methyl carbocation. So here in the generation of the electrophile methyl cation, we are reacting this methyl chloride with this aluminium chloride. So then after that, there is a formation of the methyl carbocation. So you can see here HCH3 positive, this is your methyl carbocation is formed. In your step second, the electrophile attack this methyl carbocation, then attack the pi system of this benzene ring, and there is a formation of this non-aromatic carbocation. Now there is a formation of this non-aromatic carbocation. After that, this positive sign is then delocalized to the molecule. So in the benzene ring, this positive sign is then resonating. Okay, after that, in the step third, you can see the aromaticity is restored by the loss of proton. So here you can see there is a loss of proton from here, and the methyl atom to the carbon atom to which the methyl group is attached. So where the methyl group is attached, from that position, this hydrogen is removed from there, and there is a formation of this. You can see this toluene is formed, or you can see methyl benzene is formed. Next is your finally the proton. Now here this that proton that is removed from the benzene ring then react with this AlCl4, and after that the Cl will remove from this AlCl4, and there is a formation of this catalyst that is your aluminium chloride, and there is a product formed that is your hydrochloric acid. And the carbocation can rearrange during the triple Krebs alkylation reaction, leading to the formation of unpredicted products. One example is the formation of isopropyl benzene by the reaction of propyl chloride with benzene. So here you can see the carbocation can also be rearranged, okay, in your Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So there can be the formation of the unpredicted product also. There can be an unpredicted product formed also. So the one example is your this. When your benzene is reacting with this propyl chloride, if benzene is reacting with this propyl chloride, then there can be a formation of this 2, 3, 4. So here this product can be a minor product, and there will be a two product formed. Okay, isopropyl benzene is also formed here. So there will be a two form. One is your major product, and the other one is your minor product. Now, what will be the student outcome? So here they are going to know, or you can say they will learn about the product that are formed from benzene by a nitration, where we are using nitro, sulfonation, sulfur dioxide, halogenation, halogens are used, Friedel-Crafts alkylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation. So the benzene, after reacting with this electrophile, there is a happening of the electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. And there are products formed from these benzene. So student will going to know about these products that are formed from benzene via this nitration, sulfonation, and this halogenation, or Friedel-Crafts alkylation, or by the Friedel-Crafts acylation. So the questions, these are some of the questions. First is your aromatic compound undergo which type of reaction? So the aromatic compounds undergo which type of reaction? Electrophilic substitution reaction, electrophilic addition reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction, the nucleophilic addition reaction. So the electrophilic, the aromatic compounds undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. Next, does benzene decolorize bromine? No. Benzene decolorize bromine. Yes. Benzene decolorize bromine. So third question is your, what is the product F? So here a structure is given, the benzene ring is given, and here we are reacting it in the presence of this acid chloride, and in the presence of Lewis acid catalyst. So here the product form will be the C. C is your acyl chloride. So here the product form will be benzoyl chloride. So this is your Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. Next is your, which is most reactive in electrophilic substitution? These four molecules are given. So in this, in your electrophilic substitution reaction, this methoxy product is more reactive in electrophilic substitution reaction. Next question is your, which is the least reactive in electrophilic substitution reaction? So in this case, the least reactive is your C, that is your COCH3. This is your least reactive in your electrophilic substitution. Next is your which of the following statement regarding Friedel-Crafts reaction is wrong. So alkylation of benzene with an alkyl chloride requires only a catalytic amount of Lewis acid such as aluminium chloride. Alkylation of benzene with an alcohol requires only a catalytic amount of bronze acid such as phosphoric acid. Acetylation of benzene with acetic chloride, acetyl chloride requires only a catalytic amount of Lewis acid. The acetylation of benzene with acetic anhydride requires more than one equivalent of a Lewis acid. So the answer is your C. Acetylation of benzene with acetyl chloride requires only a catalytic amount of a Lewis acid. Next is your which of the following statement regarding electrophilic aromatic substitution is wrong. Acetyl and cyano substituents are both deactivating and amidirecting. Alkyl groups are activating and ortho para directing. Amino groups are meta directing and amino groups are and ortho para directing. Fluoro and methoxy substituents are both deactivating and ortho para directing. So option C is wrong regarding your electrophilic aromatic substitution, that fluoro and methoxy substituents are both deactivating and ortho para directing. Next is your which will be the main product upon bromination of phenyl benzoate with bromine and AlBr3. So here the answer is your C. Next, which of the following statement regarding electrophilic aromatic substitution is wrong? Sulfonation of toluene is reversible. Friedel-Crafts alkylation of benzene can be reversible. Or Friedel-Crafts alkylation with the primary alkyl chloride may involve rearrangement. Friedel-Crafts acylation of nitrobenzene really readily gives the meta substitution product. So answer D. Answer D is your right regarding electrophilic aromatic substitution is wrong. The last question is which gives a para nitro compound as the main product upon nitration with the nitric acid sulfuric acid. So its answer is your C. So these are the references from where you can study this topic. And thank you so much. In our next lecture, we will discuss about the effect of substituents on benzene rate.